What's up, everyone? I'm Christina Jordan, and I am your master nutritionist who's also personally lost over half my body size. That's 134 pounds, you guys. Best of all, I've totally reversed type 2 diabetes. I no longer have it, no symptoms, no nothing. And I want to show you what I eat as both a mom and a nutritionist. And so just to kind of give you an idea, a sneak peek on my little world. So we just got back from vacation and my fridge was completely bare. And I thought this is a great time, not only to restock, but also because we were on vacation, it's really time to detox and get back on track. So I thought, you know what, this is a good time to show you what we eat. Now, what I want to point out before we begin is that, you know, I'm a mom. We have a family. So some of the foods in here, you know, there is some compromising going on because we do have kids. And so not everything's perfect, but I want to give you an idea of what some of my favorites are and our family's favorites. Okay, so what I kind of want to point out is what you're going to see a lot of in the fridge. You see a lot of fresh fruits, a lot of vegetables, and I want to give you some tips on what I do to keep my fruits and vegetables living longer. So, for example, right here, this is some beautiful organic green onion, and I learned this tip from a friend of mine who is a pharmacist and also an organic pharmacist, and he does urban farming, meaning he creates amazing foods like fruits and vegetables that are living. And he actually shared this tip with me and I loved it, but he said, don't leave it in the bag. Don't leave it in those plastic bags, your beautiful vegetables, because they're alive. And just like you, what would happen if you were left in a plastic bag? You would die. And it's the same for these vegetables. So put them in a little vase or jar with water and they'll live so much longer. And plus it looks kind of pretty in your fridge, but this will last 3 times longer than if you just put it in the bag, right? So this will help you save money, not waste food, but it also makes your food healthier for you because you want to try and eat fruits and vegetables as soon as possible from being either like uprooted or plucked from a vine or the tree or whatever. So fresh is truly best. Now I do this also with like my asparagus. So we trimmed it, put it in a little cup. Don't leave it in the bag. This will taste so much better if you just put it in a little cup with some water and it'll taste great. So this will last so much longer. And then also you can buy vegetables that are already kind of like this. Like for example, this is called living lettuce. And see how it's got the roots? It's alive, you guys. This is still alive. And so you can find this everywhere. Costco, Walmart, Target, Sprouts, health food stores, grocery stores. This is now everywhere. And I suggest pay a little extra and this will last forever. So I talk to a lot of people who tell me, you know, healthy eating, it's so expensive. So I wanted to give you a little tip on what we do to, we save tons of money. And I have 3 sons and they eat a lot and they're very active and energetic. So what I've learned is you don't want to just buy 2-3 weeks of fruits and vegetables. They're going to go bad. We buy groceries and restock like every 3 to 4 days. It tastes better, it's better for you, and you know, it allows you to kind of have some freedom and flexibility to try new things. And that is one tip, especially if you're a parent, is let your kids just kind of pick out things they want to try. And you know, for example, like these blueberries right here, they won't last us more than a few days, but that's okay because I plan for that. We save money, your kids, you, your family, you're eating fresh. And that's what you really want, because this is interesting. If you've got, like, let's say you got some apples left on the counter from 3 weeks ago, throw those things away. They have been dead far too long. Like, for example, these little guys right here, these are little pink ladies. They're organic. And, you know, for a whole bag of 12, I think it's like $4. It's definitely a little bit more expensive than just buying regular, but it's worth it. And I want to explain why you want to do organic and why you want to go fresh. Well, organic is better because at least we're supposed to be guaranteed that we're getting not genetically modified foods. You've probably heard of GMOs. GMOs are genetically modified foods. And I'm gonna give you a little history lesson because this is crazy. And I was like a lot of people who was like, well, what's the big deal? You know, is organic really worth it? And back when I was first losing my weight, it was really expensive to go organic. I mean, I remember paying almost $10 for one apple once. And now it's so much more affordable. But the problem is, if you're not buying organic, you're not being guaranteed. There's no rules in the United States. There's no laws, no legal regulations that they have to label it as GMO if it's GMO. It's wrong, and I think it should be changed. But for now, that's what we have to work with here in America. Now, in other countries, if you're watching this and you live in other countries, you may have rules that state that. But in the United States, we don't have that. It's wrong, but it is what it is. And so if you're eating GMO, this is what GMO is, guys. It's genetically modified food, meaning it was made chemically, designed chemically. It's not natural. And so they've actually done studies on GMO foods where they've seen and placed one GMO corn versus a non-GMO corn, and literally the bugs won't eat it, the squirrels wouldn't eat it, the birds wouldn't touch it. So why the heck would you eat it? Why should we eat it? Why should our kids eat it? GMOs have been linked to so many diseases, including cancer, including mood disorders, brain disorders, you name it. Autism, they say that kids that live near these the cornfields with GMO cornfields, that they're getting, their rates of autism are like tripled. It's crazy. I have a friend who literally, they lived next to a cornfield and her son has autism. And it's just, I gave her this book that I was reading in one of my courses, and she just could not believe it. But here's the deal, you guys. Have you heard of Monsanto? Monsanto were the creators of GMOs. And this is what's crazy, you guys. Back during World War II, Monsanto was the creators of Agent Orange. Ever heard of it? It is a chemical. They created chemicals of mass destruction, chemicals of warfare, chemicals to kill people, and then thought, hey, you know what? It's all about the money. They switched from creating chemicals to kill people to creating chemicals hidden in food that's killing people. There's a reason why cancer is so high. There's a reason why it's just skyrocketed, why hormone disorders and diseases have skyrocketed. And I truly see that it's linked to these GMO foods that we're eating. And there's a reason why GMO is illegal in other countries. So when I say go organic, it might be a few extra dollars. It's worth it, especially if you are a parent. I really feel that you've got to consider this, not doing the GMOs for your kids. And then of course for your sake as well. So what you see in here are a lot of fruits and vegetables. It's true, but they are organic. And yeah, it might cost you a couple extra dollars, but just hey, just skip Starbucks for a couple of days and you've already covered your cost. Speaking of Starbucks, let's talk about that. Because again, we're talking about chemicals and they use a lot and they're expensive. And so I do a lot. I make my own cold brew at home. And when I don't have time to do that, I'll buy just a cold brew. I love cold brew. And you do not have to skip your coffee and to be healthy and to lose weight. You just have to do it a different way. And so for me, I'll just show you what my favorites are. And there might be other brands out there that I still need to try. And if you are one of those brands and you're watching this or you know one of them, send it my way. I'd love to try it. But I like Stoke cold brew coffee. I enjoy that. And again, what I like about it is it's not packed full of a bunch of sugar. It has literally 10 calories and 2 carbs. That's it. That saves me a ton of carbs and calories from hitting a drive-thru somewhere. And then what you put in it is just as important as what you're drinking. So I found this amazing vegan creamer. I really like Ripple. It's plant-based, it's really good. And here's why you wanna skip the regular creamer. Just like what's happening to our poor little produces from GMOs and all the pesticides, same thing's happening to our cows. So all our dairy, a lot of them are being pumped full of chemicals, growth hormones, regular hormones. They're being given all these antibiotics that are weakening their immune system. And of course, they're being fed the GMO, whatever's cheapest, grains. So they're being fed this crap, and what they eat, you eat. So if you're breaking out, having cystic acne, if you're dealing with hormone imbalances, low sex drive, depression, get rid of the dairy. You guys, if you're feeling like you're gaining weight in your midsection, huge sign that you're off and you need to get rid of the dairy. Try using something like Ripple, which is, again, plant-based. I like it, found it at Target. Also Sprouts, a lot of grocery chains carry this now. But again, like I said, we are a family, and we gotta think about everybody in the family. It's not just about me. And so we do have some milk in here, but it's about choosing a better milk. And I really like this brand here. It's called Fairlife, and it has the DHA, it has the omega-3s, and it's triple filtered, meaning they're taking and making sure that there's no crap in it. They filter out the lactose, and what I love about it is it's from cows that are grass-fed. And that's what you want. If you're going to do milk, cheeses, proteins, you wanna go grass-fed, which in my fridge, you will actually see. I have some grass-fed beef right here. I do not touch beef unless it is grass-fed. We're only gonna do grass-fed. And there's a reason, you guys. The way that the fat is in grass-fed beef is regular than traditional beef. Traditional beef will clog your arteries. It'll cause issues with cholesterol, and grass-fed beef will not do that. Plus, it tastes better. Again, the cows are fed better, which means you're eating better. Because whatever they eat, you eat. And that's what we do. You do the grass-fed milk, grass-fed butter, grass-fed cheese if you're gonna do that, or you can try vegan cheese. We've done it all, we tried it all. And then of course, we also cook with healthy fats, like organic coconut oil, organic olive oil, we have avocado oil. We cook with all of that. You don't have to miss out. But the biggest thing, like I said, is that overall, you're going healthy. And then I wanna talk about two things that are kinda like indulgences, and that is, we all like a little sweetness in our life, right? And these are called sweet leaf stevia drops. And if you're looking for an alternative to sugar, and you definitely want to skip the chemicals, try this. And if you've tried stevia before and you're like, ugh, I don't like it because it's, you know, kind of grainy and has a weird aftertaste, try the drops. I think you'll really like them. I love them in my coffee. So, and I got the vanilla cream, but there's all kinds of flavors you can try. And again, I got it at Sprouts, but you can get it online as well. Okay guys, so lastly, remember, we are a family. So my kids pack their lunches for school every day, and I wanna give you a few tips. So they actually will pick whatever fruits and vegetables they like. This is little bits of organic broccoli. They'll have some fresh fruit, and then they make sandwiches. So a lot of people wanna know, can I have bread? Well, the answer is yes, but you gotta choose the right kind of bread. This bread here, I suggest going with sprouted grain. We just have the Dave's Killer bread, and you do have to keep it refrigerated because it's sprouted, it's living. And just the biggest thing with bread is don't go with the traditional crappy white bread that's gonna be filled with chemicals and preservatives. Overall, as you can see, it's all about just eating real food. Food that was alive, food that was once alive, and again, trying to eat it as fresh as possible. So just skip the canned goods, just go fresh. Don't buy weeks and weeks at a time and waste a ton of money. Buy fresh, shop every few days, and I promise your body, you will love it. And again, we do use some spices, and like we do use a lot of mustards and, you know, lime juice and different things like that. We're a family. And so, again, it's all about balance. But I promise you, if you just give this a try, you're gonna look better, you're gonna feel better. I've lost over 134 pounds, you guys. I've kept it off 10 years. I feel great, and I truly give my credit for my success to nutrition. I mean, nutrition is a huge part of my life, and that's why I went back to school to become a master nutritionist and help others. Nutrition is amazing, you guys, and if you just try it, you're gonna look better, look younger, feel younger, feel amazing, and your health is gonna go through the roof. Plus, you'll probably shed a few pounds. So give it a try, everyone. Learn to eat like a nutritionist.